White wine, please.
You look familiar.
Oh, I drink here a lot.
No. Were you at the hospital earlier?
Yeah, I was. I'm a firefighter. I was bringing something.
Oh my God. Yes, you are the one who ran in with the nose.
Yeah, Captain Maya Bishop.
Dr. Karina De Luca. Well, okay, if I buy you a drink, would you tell me the story of how he ended up carrying a nose in a plastic bag?
Sorry, I'm drinking alone tonight.
Okay. Are you sure?
Maybe not.
Mama is relaxed, and if you're relaxed, there is really nothing to be done. Let nature do what it does.
Right, but I'm not relaxed at all, and neither is she.
Don't you run into burning buildings for a living?
Yes, but I'm usually not running into buildings that have babies flying out of vaginas in them.
Well, first of all, babies don't fly out. They slowly slide out, and it is perfectly natural and beautiful, especially if you stay calm.
So, like, turn up the Enya.
Turn up the Enya, yes. And Maya, I don't know you all that well yet, but it is plain to see that you're excellent at whatever you put your mind to. Gold medals and fire captains and...
I'm good at a lot of things.
I have no doubt. You can do this. I'm not worried about you or the mama.
Can I call you later and not talk about babies?
You can call me anytime and... talk about anything you want.
Well, that's one way to get to know me better. I find it is the fastest way.
Hi.
What are you doing here?
I saw Warren at the hospital and he said it was a tough day, so I brought you lasagna.
You can't just come to my work.
But Warren just said...
Karina, you're hot, but all we did was hook up. I don't need a girlfriend.
Wow. Okay. My apologies. It was nice meeting you, then.
I'm sorry. I'm...
rude?
Broken?
I'm not in the habit of fixing broken people.
I understand. Lasagna smells almost as good as you.
Does it?
Cold, but I should go back to work now.
On the truck.
Sorry, I'm not very good at American idioms.
On the truck. I'm the truck that drunk and plowed into Station 19 and destroyed an entire family.
Hey.
I'm the truck.
Sei bellissima, sei forte, sei tenace.
I don't understand a word of this, but somehow it's working.
Go shine your light, bella. Tell your truth. Dammi un bacio.
Was that kiss me?
Yeah.
You know, I was thinking. Could you take some days off? Could we try to go somewhere?
I thought you have to work.
I have some personal days saved up.
How many?
Like 100 maybe. I don't take days off, but I would like to try.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yes.
Really?
Take it.
Okay, vacations are so stressful.
Sweet broken Maya. Go, drink a pina colada, then sex up that gorgeous Italian woman of yours and stop thinking about work.
Are you ready?
Yeah, just,
You don't look ready.
Just had to call the station. No one ever remembers your stuff.
Okay. Then, all this and some fruity drinks will be waiting for you at the pool.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you for making me come outside.
Thank you for coming outside. But Maya, you're very white. Don't you think you should cover?
Shut up.
Hey, ladies. Name's Todd.
Hi, Todd. Bye, Todd.
Oh, man, you're gonna go and break my heart like that?
Mm-hmm.
Nah, see, we were just stopping by to see if we could buy y'all some drinks.
We have our own drinks. Thanks.
Oh, cool. So you two on a girls' trip?
Something like that.
Sweet. Just blowing off a little steam, huh?
Look, man, we're just trying to have a nice time, so would you mind?
Oh, you having a nice time is all I want.
Oh, my God, gli uomini sono tutti degli idioti.
What's that? Spanish? I took Spanish. Hola, ¿cómo está?
Okay, Todd, you want to have some fun?
Hell yeah.
Look, you can do more push-ups than me. You can buy us drinks, but if I can do more push-ups than you, you buy us drinks, and then you leave us the hell alone.
I like a feisty woman. I'll do them with one hand just to keep it even.
Oh, thank you. I want to see this.
After you.
Another round of drinks on their tab, please.
And fries. And mozzarella sticks. Thank you.
You're right. Vacation is fun.
Mm-hmm. Don't do that.
No. 4 alarms.
Anything you can help with from 1,000 miles away?
It's a 4-alarm fire. They're expecting it to get to 5. They're calling everyone in.
They'll call everyone else. They are going to put out the fire.
It's... Yeah, I'm the captain. I should be there. A 5-alarm fire is,
Maya?
I should be with him. I've never been this far away when... Now I'm too far away.
Maya? Okay, Maya, you're having a panic attack. It's okay. It's okay. I've got you. They are going to put out the fire.
Oh, what if somebody gets hurt?
There are emergencies in every state and in every country doing every hour and every minute of every single day, and they'll get solved and fixed even without you there. It will be okay. They will be okay.
But
Okay. Look at me. Yeah, look at me. Your eyes only need to be on me. No. No eyes forward. Eyes only on me. Good. Breathe. No eyes forward. Good. We shouldn't be doing this at work.
We are in the taxpayer's
center. And they're not paying you to make out with me.
We could reverse them.
Okay. Yeah.
Hi, Captain Bishop. Sorry to interrupt. Your mom is here.
Mom?
Hi. Surprise!
What are you doing? You didn't... No warning. Why?
I thought it was finally time to see where my daughter works. Big time, Captain.
Hi.
Are you one of Maya's fire women?
No, I'm not a firefighter. I'm Dr. Karina De Luca.
Oh, you're my daughter's doctor.
I am a doctor, but I'm not Maya's. I am actually...
Oh, did I walk in at a bad time?
No. I was just about to leave. I've already wasted enough taxpayers' time, but it was wonderful to meet you.
Likewise.
Mom, what are you doing here?
You have it.
No.
I love that.
What is this?
Yeah,
hey.
Oh, hi. I know you needed help getting ready for your spaghetti dinner, so we helped.
I didn't ask you to do that.
I know.
Maya, we were just trying to make it easier for you.
Mom.
T-minus 2 hours until doors open. Chop, chop.
Oh, wait, who's on garlic duty?
Not it.
Someone's got to do it.
Proby, you're on garlic duty.
But I just
did. Proby, garlic or suspension, your choice.
Yeah, okay, I like garlic.
Mom, thank you, but you can't just show up at my work and take over.
I didn't think...
Dad never laid a hand on us.
He didn't have to. His rage, his moods...
Yeah, he was tough. He could be a jerk, he could be mean, but that doesn't mean he abused us.
Tough is grounding you for breaking curfew. Abuse is making you walk home 20 miles from your track meet for coming in second.
I came in first, actually. But I didn't beat my own time.
Maya, come with me to my next therapy session.
I beat it the next time. You know, I agree. You need therapy. And I'm good.
I, too, love my dad very much. He's brilliant. He's funny. He's my hero in so many ways. But that's why it took me so long to realize that he wasn't okay. It took me so long to realize that it isn't normal to live your life on eggshells. Maya, denial is a strong force, and the abuser your mom described outside is still abusive.
I'm not in denial. I won a gold medal because of my dad. I am the youngest fire captain in Seattle and this station's first female captain because of my dad. I am not in denial. I am pissed. Who will save
your soul if you won't save your own?
Oh, is it just me or orgasms better in the daylight?
It isn't just you.
I actually did a whole study on female orgasms.
Oh, it's a study I'd like to see.
How do you feel?
Right now? Amazing.
I mean, about your mama?
I haven't talked to her since the spaghetti dinner.
Don't you think you should try?
Why?
Because she's your mom and she's hurting.
And that's not my problem. She wants to ruin her life and live in a motel forever because of some raised voices. That's her choice.
I get it. This is hard for you, Maya, but don't you think maybe there is some truth in what your mom says?
Stop. Please.
How long are you going to angry chop at me?
I'm just chopping.
Do you know my dad has bipolar 1?
You said that?
And my sweet baby brother has inherited it.
Are you talking about you, or are you trying to draw some kind of parallel? Because if it's you, I'm all in, but there is no mental illness in my family.
With or without mental illness, that the human brain is brilliant and it is devious and it walls off what it doesn't want to know.
Got it.
So you're talking about me?
What I'm trying to say, Maya, is that your mind is brilliant. And maybe you think you're too smart to be in denial. Maybe you think you're too smart to have been abused.
Okay, I'm not interested in talking.
Just trying to help.
He never hit me.
That's not the only way you abuse somebody, Maya. My dad has never hit me either. He has never hit my brother. But that doesn't mean that we were not abused. Psychological abuse, verbal abuse, they are real.
I don't want to fight with you.
I don't want to fight either.
Then I think you should go.
What? This is not how you handle a fight. Maya, I'm here for you. I'm not leaving.
Okay, I need to run. So I'm gonna go on a run.
With me, I wanna stay strong when it's so wrong. I try to stay on my feet.
I thought you left.
I almost did, but then I thought you might need.
I don't need anything except space.
And I ain't got no control.
I can see that you're pushing me away, and I wanna give you space.
But give me space.
I understand that you're going through a lot, and I'm trying not to be mad at you.
Well, I just slept with Jack an hour ago, so be mad at that.
And I ain't got no control. I tell myself I gotta keep.
Hold the things we miss.
Karina.
What do you want?
I'm an idiot. You're right. I was abused. My dad was abusive. But that is no excuse for what I did to you. And I just please take me back. I love you. And I've never said that about anyone before. Except my brother, so it means something. I love you, Karina. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Just please forgive me.
Oh, my God, forgive me.
Oh,
sorry. She cheated on me with her ex-boyfriend. And then you throw it in my face just to hurt me. And what am I supposed to do now? Forget that? Am I supposed to trust you?
I don't know. But I'm okay spending every day trying to convince you to. Forgive her.
Oh.
I'm sorry. If you love her, forgive her.
When scars are left behind.
I love you, Maya. Come kiss me.
Do you have to go? Tell me, do you?
And what if I did that?
You are a very mean fire captain. You know that, right?
I mean, you could come in and visit me at work.
I mean, it's not safe. Think about all the people we're both interacting with.
Okay, well, this is torture. It's been 3 weeks now.
I know, but if my boss is not seeing her husband, I'm not gonna see my girlfriend.
Well, what about just a super short little visit? No kissing on the mouth.
It's not safe, and I suspect impossibile.
I mean, aren't you a little curious? I have to go do my job now. My other job.
Okay, it is a little wrong how happy you make me when I'm at work, in a hospital, in the middle of a pandemic.
You're welcome. Bye.
BC.
Are you really, really here, or am I just really tired?
Both, I'm guessing.
What?
I missed you. And I've brought you something.
Okay, I'm walking away from you now before I start breaking all the rules.
Good.
Move in with me.
What?
Quarantining is basically just moving in together. But I don't want to just basically do anything with you. I want to do everything for real. And I know that we have barely spent 3 days together since I broke your trust, but I'm hoping that me asking you
to move in with me is a sign that I'm all the way in.
Actually, I came here to ask you the exact same thing. I'll do yours if you do mine.
How do you make even nasal swabbing sound sexy?
Make a protein shake and drink it on my way to work. Okay, that might be better than sex.
That sounds like a challenge.
Oh, I feel guilty being this happy when people are dying every day.
You feel guilty that Warren is not seeing his wife and kids and we're here in the shack.
In the shack?
On the shack? What is it?
Oh, you mean shacking up.
Yeah. Yeah.
Shacking up.
Yes. Shacking up. Where are you shacking up?
I always dreamed of living inside a buca de pepo, and now we do.
Trina is hanging all of this to dry. She says that it reminds her of home. What do I do with this?
I don't know. Throw a dinner party?
Oh, you like that one. Se chiama Basilio. Pesto flavored and made from unpasteurized sheep's milk.
Ah, we're gonna be late.
I love you.
Hey. Shower first.
Seriously?
Bambina.
Okay, I'm sorry, but what is with our kitchen becoming a cheese cellar?
It reminds me of home.
Yeah, I know, you said that, but it is starting...
Maya, my home is really scary right now. It's worse in here, and here is really bad. I'm scared for my dad. He was never the one to follow the rules, and I cannot be there to take care of him and to make sure that he does what he's supposed to. So, it feels good to look up and to be reminded of the good memories of Italy instead of the constant fear and worry.
I'm sorry.
You don't have to be. Gotta go get ready to bring some babies into this terrifying world.
I did that today.
You did what?
I brought a baby into this terrifying world.
You did?
I mean, brought, maybe more like caught.
Tell me everything.
Well, first I'm gonna shower, and then I will tell you all about it. Naked.
No.
In bed.
No.
What do you need?
I saw a woman at the hospital this morning, and they think she's associated with what happened last night.
Yeah, well, we're not gonna let her get away this time.
Yeah.
Okay? And she's gotta be connected somehow to the guy that your team brought in last night. It's too much of a coincidence.
Did you call the police?
Yeah, because I worked out so well last
night. Yeah, we tried the police, but they told us they'll follow up.
So your plan is just to follow her?
No, my plan is to not let this woman kidnap and torture other teenagers.
If we can follow her to a location or her home
or something, at least we can give the police an address.
Okay, Karina, this is crazy. You can't just follow some stranger all over the streets of
Seattle.
Look,
she's turning right.
Yeah.
Turn right.
Got it.
There we go. Okay, don't lose her.
No. She's stopping.
Pull over.
Okay.
Pull over.
Who's stopping? Opal?
Okay, stop. Okay, Duluka, what are you doing?
Andre.
Hey. Look, she's carrying something. You see that?
Who's that?
I don't know.
She's talking to some men.
Hey, Karina, these people could be really dangerous.
Yeah, they're dangerous to teenage girls. That's why we're here.
Stay in the car.
Look, you want to help? Cut through the red tape and get the police here right now.
Okay, we're on it. Just please wait for the police.
We will.
I'm not making any promises.
Hey. He stabbed me.
Help!
Jesus, clear path, please. Coming through, clear path. Clear path.
Okay, Eva.
Captain Maya Bishop from Station 19. We have a doctor. A 35-year-old male with an abdominal stab wound coming your way. He's tachycardic and hypotensive. Warren.
Got it. I got it.
Okay. Did they get her?
What?
Did they get her?
Yeah, they got her. They got her.
Is this a story of come at my most so getting listed? Crazy.
It's a lot any crazier than finding you lying in the hallway at 3 a.m.
I can't get comfortable anywhere.
You want to give the bed or the couch another shot?
Too soft. When something is too soft and nice and comfortable right now, it makes me want to cry. And I can't cry anymore because it's exhausting and it gives me a headache. And I'm already so tired, but I can't fall asleep. And sleeping is the only thing that will turn off the crazy guilt screaming in my brain. So I'm in the shower to try to fall asleep.
Karina, none of this is your fault. You want to scream? Would that make you feel better? Okay. Then scream. Your brother died, Karina. You're allowed to wake up the neighbors.
He didn't die. He was murdered.
Scream.
Too soft. Too soft.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I have to go to Italy.
What?
I have to tell my dad, and I think the best way to do it is in person.
Karina, take a breath. Let's talk this through.
I don't know how it's going to react to the news, and I just need to be there in case he goes crazy or something.
There are no flights to Italy right now. The border is closed there and here, and even if you could get there, we're in a pandemic, remember?
Okay, I feel like there's so much that I have to do and I don't even know how.
Okay, what do you want? What do you need? What can I do?
I have to organize the funeral. I have to contact his landlord. I have to call the bank to sort out all the details and the paperwork. I have to tell my dad. But what I want to do right now is scream. I want to scream until my throat hurts more than my head and my stomach and my chest. I just want to scream so that some of this pressure goes away.
So scream. Do it. Let it out.
I can't. I can't.
Did you sleep?
No, but I tried in the shower like a lunatic.
Well, I got everything sorted out with the funeral home.
You called them?
I called everyone. I did the whole list. I did all the things.
Thank you. No one's ever done that for me. Any chance you could call my dad for me, too?
I wish I could. It's one you gotta do on your own.
I know. I'm so scared to tell him.
I know.
I'm gonna try again.
To sleep?
To scream.